Si fam pesu.
Moyo wangu, moyo wangu. Si fam pesu. Moyo wangu, moyo wangu. Si fam pesu.
Imitima yacu ihimbaza Imana.
Our hearts praise praises the Lord.
Who come to the one very abuse?
As the first preacher has said. And I thank my interpreter. Let's continue our. We all know the story of these men. When Moses sent the 12 men to inspect the country or the land. The land of Canaan that the Lord promised to them.
Hallelujah.
As the Lord. 12 men came. From those 12, they brought bad reports. They said, the men that we saw, they are so great. So strong. And we saw ourselves as grasshoppers before them. You know grasshoppers. It's like myself standing here and then I see small whenever you want, you can step on it and it's gonna die. Because it has no power. It has no value.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. In this journey, there are things that we see as very scary. Or other people that we meet or on the journey that discourage us. But for Joshua and the Caleb, they brought a good news for them.
Hallelujah.
Amen. They said, be comfortable because we'll get to that land. Anyone who can read the same Numbers chapter 14.
14.
From verse
8
to
9.
Gonna read.
Akiduhe kandi ari igihugu cy'amata n'ubuki. Icyakora ntimugomere Uwiteka kandi ntimutinye bene icyo gihugu. Tuzabarya nk'imitsima ntibagifite. Ikibakingira kandi Uwiteka ari mu ruhande rwacu ntimubatinye. Haleluya.
Amen.
Uwo ni Yosuwa na Kalebu bazanye izo nkuru.
That's Joshua and Caleb who brought this report.
Mbwira nawe kugira ngo utume abantu 12.
Tell me how you can send 12 people.
Abantu 10 bakuzanira inkuru imeze.
10 people bring you back a bad report.
N'abandi babiri bakuzanira inkuru nziza.
And 2 people bring you a good report.
Utiri ujya kure na kure uhita ugenda mu namba nyinshi kuko nibyo bikora nibyo bigezweho.
Without going too far, you will definitely accept the recommendations or the report of many people.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Think about 10 people and different individuals bringing the bad reports. How would you feel if you were among the people who were listening to them?
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. First, they said they are tall men.
And
who, with a great size and very strong, they saw themselves as grasshoppers before them. That only, when you hear that report, even if you have any energy or you feel that you can continue, all the excitement will go.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. But I thank God because he does not follow the majority.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
As long as
Murit Kumina nayo mufatanije.
What God has told you, whether you are one or two people, doesn't change.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Muru rugendo rero hari ibyo tubona tukabona ari nk'inzige.
In this life, there are things that we see as these giants men. You see them and then you think that they are stronger than you. And then you see that there is no way you can
Hallelujah.
Even tackle them. But if God is pleased with us,
Hallelujah.
Amen. Is really God pleased by you? Is God pleased by me? This new year that we have started, is God happy with us?
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
The
question is for you and me.
What if we take up Christian?
If God is pleased with us, we will get to that land.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If we take up Christian,
if God is happy with us, whatever struggles that we go through, God will reward us. If God is pleased with us, He will build
it.
If God is pleased with us, He will heal
our lives.
If God is pleased,
He will
do what our hearts desire.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Is God really happy with you?
Hallelujah.
Amen. May God help us. We are in times where we just follow things. But if we have really accepted the word of God and listen to His voice,
Hallelujah.
Amen. We have to be like Joshua.
Because
they are the only two men who went to this land and were able to behave as they should. They said, if God is pleased with us, they knew a secret. Even though they are tall, we will eat them as like bread.
Hallelujah.
If God is pleased with us, we will eat them as hot bread.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If
God is happy with us, there is no problem that we cannot get to that.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I
said, why did they talk about bread or ugali? Is that because it's soft? Even a young child who doesn't have teeth, you only put in the soup and then give it to him. He will But when God gives it to you, you will swallow it as a
Hallelujah.
You will never even remember that it exists. You will never remember because God has given it to you. God will only give it to you if He is pleased with you.
What
people of Israel had to do and so that God can accept them was to be pleased by Him. That was a difference, separating from bad behavior. Separating from sin. Separating from a sin or anything that cannot take them to the cross. And have a humble heart. When you
sin,
you know that you have sinned and then you can repair.
Hallelujah.
Amen. If God is pleased with us, He will give us our enemies and
Hallelujah.
As we started this year, let's ask God whatever has happened to us so that we can swallow them.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
So that God can hand it to our hands.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Give it to our hands. But the only thing that God wants from us
is
to be holy, to be humble,
kugendana
n'Imana
nk'uko ijambo twumvishije ejo hashize
usemera
Imana ituyobora
emera
Imana ikakuyobora
n'ukuri
nta kizabuza icyo yagusezeranyije
kandi
nta kizabuza ko ibyo yaguhaye uzabirya
nk'imitsi
haleluya
mbese
ni iki kikubuza kugira ngo ibyo kugira ngo ugere ku gakiza cyangwa kugira ngo Imana ikwishimire.
What is stopping you from being holy or getting closer to God?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ngabo banaki n'ubugari bareba.
Those Nephilim, even though they are tall.
N'ubugari banini.
Even though they are really of great size.
Mwigeze mubona haba ba New Zealand.
Have you seen the people from New Zealand?
Hari ureba ukabona yagutura kugize gutya.
They are people that you see, you think that one person will be able to lead up with one hand. But if God is pleased with you, I'm not even scared of his size. Not even scared of whether they have much power or more strength. But if God gives it them to me, I will swallow them as well. If God really gives us our enemies, our marriages will get stronger.
Buri wese nabe kukirindiro kuko aho buri wese agomba kurindira Imana yiwe.
Everyone has to be in the position where they're waiting for God.
Kwizamudiwe.
Be in your position.
Ndabizi ko twese hanga twagiye twakiraga ikiza ahantu hatandukanye.
I know that we all receive the salvation from different places.
Kwibona turi aha ngaha muri grace.
And we find ourselves in this church. But our master plan is to get to heaven. We may have started salvation from different places, but the end is the same for us. So what is most important is to really save your life. Really do what God has
called you to do.
Stand in your position because no one will be able to stand in your position. Protect your life because you don't know the time. What is really troubling you or your enemies may look like you are a grasshopper before them.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Or you may see yourself as a grasshopper before your illness. But it's just because you don't know who is in you. It's just because you don't know the
secret.
If God is pleased with you, if God is pleased with you, there is no problem. He will heal you. He will protect you. He will save our marriages. God will use us to do what is right. If God is really pleased with us, is God really pleased with you? We have different talents of
gifts.
Do we really still have the same gifts as we well received, given by the Holy Spirit? Or you have given up everything and then you are now sitting down? May God help us. If you want God to really protect you, if you want to really be able to overcome your problems, make sure that you check that God is pleased with you. Make sure that your relationship with God is still there.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Don't give up on your calling because of the problems that you are going through or because people are discouraging you.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Sometimes when you meet other women who are not saved, when you are going to have a wedding, They will tell you that, well, we have also failed. And then you
think
away, you're going, and then that may confuse.
Hallelujah.
But when God is pleased with you, what God has said to you, It may be possible that life is really troubling them. It's possible that whatever situation you are in, you can't see a way out. But I know that there is nothing is permanent. If God is pleased with you, that will become a blessing to you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Let's allow God to be pleased with our actions
in this year,
so that God can create new presence
in our lives.
So that God can create new presence in our marriages. So God can create new presence in our kids. So that God can create presence in our jobs. This year, we are still
genuine.
If God is pleased
with us,
there is no problem that
we,
if God is pleased, there is no problem we even get to December. If God is pleased, our families will even get there. The protection of God will be with us. If God is pleased with us, whatever is troubling us, we will become our possession.
Hallelujah.
Amen. If God is pleased with us, He will give you a good marriage.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He
give you a good wife.
He
give you a good husband. He give you kids who can be
spent.
If God is pleased, there is no problem we will eat what the fruits from that land. You may say to me that, I do all good stuff, why God is yet to give me anything? I don't know, but let's ask Him. But what I know is He might have promised to us. Amen. We have to wait in His God's time, the perfect
time.
Maybe He has given you something, but He's waiting what is surrounding
you.
He's waiting for you to move
on
so that what God has prepared for you can be fulfilled.
Hallelujah.
Amen. If God is pleased with us, there is no problem whatever. I know that people have
said that.
But what God has promised to us, in a good time, He will give it to us. If He really is happy, pleased with us. Sometimes you may lie to yourself and think that God is pleased with you. But the good times that you use it to have, so that can show that you have a great relationship with God, is no longer there. Come back to your position. There is a chorus that says, you make me stand on your where you can see and see me. He knows us. He looks at us. He can see
on the tower.
Oh,
the tower, yeah. Nara ni tower.
Make me stand on the tower.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He knows those towers.
Hallelujah.
He knows our towers. Where he can look and
see.
Where he called
us.
What he wants us to do.
Hallelujah.
Are you still standing in on your tower?
Is there a connection between you and God?
If the God is really pleased with that, there is no problem. We will eat fruits from that land. God bless you. This is the way
for today. Let's pray for
Pastor
Dusengere.
Let's ask the senior pastor to pray for us.
If there are things
that have separated you from God, so that
he can give you,
he can pray for us.
Adusengere mu kwezi no kwihana.
For being washed by the blood of God and being for repentance. We may be like those 10 men who bring bad
news.
There are no goods that comes from you. So that he can pray for us for this
issue.
What God has spoken about us. God bless you. As she said, everyone must have a desire that the word of God is true. True, if we believe as she said, if God is pleased with us, there is no reason to cry. There is no reason to give up hope. My dear friends, let's remember our promises. Many people have spoken to God. Others believe the word of God. This is God who is speaking. So why we cannot get the plan that God has given us? I have been encouraged. God bless you. She has encouraged me. I will not be afraid. Truly, let me tell you, I will not be accepted to faith.
Amen.
I will finally touch your lips with my teeth. My hair will go. I'm the king, she is.
Amen. ubwoko bwawe warangize mu kwitotomba warangirize mu bindi warangirize mu kurikora urakoze kuba hariye Imana urakoze kuba hari ibisigaye ndabasengera muri uyu mwaka mushya Yesu ubabere umwaka w'ibyishimo ubabere umwaka wo kujabuka yanga uko wabwira abigishwa bawe ngo bajabuke bashyire hakurya emerera ubwoko bwawe ya bamwe basigaje kereti bamwe bari kereti amena haleluya amena haleluya ya bajabuke bashyire hakurya umushima ubegereye umwaka bakajabuka bagasimba bagerageza barimo bari kubaracamo bagasimba ibibazo bari kubaracamo bagasimba indwara bari kubaracamo bagasimba icyo ari cyo cyose cyatumye bongera kurira uyu mwaka bibone ko ari abanyankomezi atari aho gutsindwa atari aho kurira atari aho kwihebura abana si ibyabo hano maze babikomorerwe muri uyu mwaka babikomorerwe ari byabo byapfuye yaba byarazuke yaba byarazuke Yesu abamutse abasaza babo abamutse ibibazo by'abasaza babo abamutse ibibazo by'abagabo babo abamutse ibibazo kuriya na kuriya na kuriya Yesu uyu mwaka w'ibihumbi bibiri na mirongo ine na kabiri babikomorerwe mu gushima uyu mwaka w'ibihumbi bibiri na mirongo ine na kabiri tubonye abagabo bazohagarara ahera hawe bagushima ibyamamyanye mu myaka tudaharuye ibyamamyanye mu mazi tudaharuye ibyamamyanye mu minsi tudaharuye n'amayiga tudaharuye Yesu n'amasaha tudaharuye n'imisegonda aho twari kudondora iby'imyanya reka ndazi yuko ngiye gukora mu musegonda misa urayikorera mu musegonda urawukorera mu mwanya umwe urawukorera turakubaye uburenganzira turakurekuye mu buzima bwacu no mu ngo zacu no mu gakiza kacu mu bukristo bwacu muri uyu mwaka w'ibihumbi mirongo ibiri na mirongo ibiri na mirongo ibiri na kabiri tukubone tugendane nawe nk'inkoko ya tukubone imbere Yesu natwe tugukurikire twishike mu byiza byacu twishike mu munezero wacu twishike mu ndirimbo zacu tuze tubona abamusimbira imbere yawe basimba atamba ashyira umunezero wawe amatabane indirimbo zongera mbere n'ababaye ingumba mu myaka iringaniye ubugumba bukumbuyeho ubugumba bupfeho ya n'ubunyakamwe buveho mu izina rya Yesu ikiri cyose kiveho mu izina rya Yesu ubwo tujya tuzi ko tukiri mu isi kandi isi nayo ntibuzi ryayo ariko turi kumwe nawe muri